Okay, well, good morning all. It is Monday morning, bright and early, about 6:15, I'm thinking. I don't know, got to figure out my clocks. God, the sun comes up early here. There's a daybreak about 4:45 in the morning. It's bizarre, which is the time we were going to get up and start prepping anyway, but I was surprised that it was already getting to be daylight. Birds chirping, making noise. So anyway, we left the, desert campground, something like that, Mount Desert. And we are headed over to the hotel to do the initial check-in for day one and the big ride out. And supposedly they're going to have a photo shoot, whatever, for all the bikes and the riders and stuff this morning. So we're going to go over there and get ready to hit the road and let this cruel and unusual punishment begin. I think we've got right at 400 miles today, which, you know, we've been doing that. That's not a big deal. And the first 2 days of the trip, we are backtracking. We're heading almost exactly the direction that we came up here. So we're just going to be doing a lot of that route in reverse. And then by the third day, we're splitting off, going more west instead of southwest, and going toward Michigan and all that. So anyway, it's going to be going to be an adventure, that's for sure. We're not sure how the days are going to go as far as picking up all of our mandatory checkpoints and any additional bonus points that are on the map. I've been having some issues getting my GPS program, but that's all on me. I could have prepared that a long time ago, and I didn't. But I've got the trick track, so you can probably see starting to pop up on here, that Scott Taggart put together. It's coming up. You'll see it. Anyway, it's got big circles and, you know, bullseyes basically for your checkpoints and your bonus points, and then a big magenta line with a directional arrow built into it that kind of shows you the direction of travel. However, it is not turn-by-turn routing, and that's what I was trying to get set up. Is I was going to load the GPX tracks in and turn it on for routing. That way it tells me next turn and whatever. So with this, you got to be watching it, and you got to zoom in, zoom out, and make sure you're still on track. And if you miss a turn, you gotta circle back around and get back on the dotted line. So we'll see how it goes. Okay, well, good morning all. This is Monday morning, July 12th. It's the beginning of the Scooter Cannonball Run. Here are our beasts. Made the pilgrimage up from Houston, Texas, 2,500 miles. Did just fine. The trailers are performing perfectly. No problems of any kind, really, except for the original chain on Adrian's bike was wearing out, so we replaced that. Everything else is doing good. We did shed some weight because we were about 20 pounds too heavy each, and we're just gonna come back around. We got all kinds of different bikes here. Looks like we got some full-size bikes, but I think they're probably just running in support capacity. Supposedly we had 86 entrants. I don't know if everybody has made registration, actually showed up for the event or not, but we've got quite a few. And I'm looking for the other SuperCub camp. We've got lots of ADV 150s. I considered getting one of those for this trip or just riding one of my PCX 150s. But yeah, your Scooter Chef, and yeah, lots and lots of bikes. People have gone to great lengths to customize these things, put light bars on them, all kinds of stuff for doing this crazy adventure. That's something. And there are people from all walks of life here. We've got ER docs and surgeons and people that own, you know, businesses, super successful people from all walks of life. This gentleman over here standing with the Forza is with Ben and Jerry's, the ice cream company, and this is his friend. We met Jerry yesterday at the cookout. He was handing out his own ice cream. So there's all kinds of people here. This is pretty neat. Somebody's has to drive upside down. That must be Ben. Ben's driving upside down. Here's Da Vinci. He rode this in from California. he and I were exchanging notes a year and a half, 2 years ago, whenever we were planning this Cub trip on the Cannonball. And he said, man, get one and I'll get one too and we'll ride on the Super Cubs. So we were kind of the defectors in the group that said, you know, Cubs should go, and they meet the requirements. So anyway, this is going to be a mad dash going around and see how many points we can get along the way. It's not a race. You got to do points. You got to get your checkpoints and your bonus points. And there's a handicapping system on the older, slower machines, get a better handicap. So this is going to be a lot of fun.
Where's your first stop today?
We don't know. I'm following GPS. We are ill prepared, but we're doing it. What I do have is one of the guys that runs this and organizes it, Scott Taggart, he made this trick track system, and what it does is it gives you bullseye rings and a line to follow. So you just stay on the dotted line, and when you start getting close to the circles, you zoom in, you zoom out, and figure out what you're supposed to be taking a picture of. Okay, thanks. Oh, hey, about lost it.
Ready?
Yep, got it. I'm ready.
And you just calm, tell me where to go.
Okay, so you want to run front and I'll steer us?
I'm a little slower than you.
Okay, all right, do it to it. On comps? Okay, I had to reset mine. For some reason I lost you. Yeah, so we just continue straight on out of here. Yeah. Well, we got some crazy ones speeding, doing 40 plus, passing in 25. I think we're going to have a few people getting tickets on this trip. Yeah, that's right. That's right. Let the foxes hunt.
It's a little chilly this morning. Overcast.
Pepper's Pizza, that's a great place. Yeah, well, I hope she does well. Women have got pretty good stamina, so I think she'll do okay. It's the butt fatigue that's the big hurdle to get over with these bikes, because you're nailed in one position, you can't really move your legs around, and you get the pressure points on your butt, so... That's right, that's what I mean. They've got that stamina, that endurance, so. I've got a pretty high threshold for pain, but I'll tell you, after 3-4 hours on this thing, I'm ready to move. Okay, we've got something coming up here that's a bonus point, it looks like. It's a checkpoint of some kind. Mile 5. There's a square, so I'm not sure what the square is. It's coming up. So let's get ready to pull off, and we'll see if we can do a picture, figure out what it is. Okay, so we're coming in on it. Let's hit the right signal, turn in. Yeah, I'm turning in here. High Seas Motel. What is this? I don't know if that was a bonus point or what. That's right. If you can't make it, that's okay. Mile 5, I'm not sure. Look in the book and see if this is a bonus. Okay, let me show you what I'm looking at on Trick Tracks, just so you know why or what I'm seeing or concerned about. See, look at this. Okay, look at this. So I don't know what this means. So I'm not sure what he's got there.
Yeah.
It was the sabotage. Okay, all right. We've got a few cars here. Gotta wait. No. Okay, hit it. Yeah, that might just be a marker of some kind to show that you're still on the route. I'm not sure. I'll, yeah, or if you're... Right, if you're zoomed out, maybe it's just a marker. I don't know what they're doing.
Oop, let them go.
Yeah, that's our guy. Gravel stretch of the day already. At least this is pretty well graded hard pack. So let's see how many of these segments there are, but we're on our way to our first bonus point, I think it is. Just following Trick Tracks on here, and Adrian has his phone running Google Maps in the background to the next waypoint. He's just plugging in whatever the name of it is, and it's giving us turn by turn. So that's probably a good combination. That way the Garmin can focus on just the route side of it. Ugh. Okay. Yeah, that's a really cool bridge. I hope my camera's recording, I don't know. Very interesting, all the support structures in the center. Oh, look at that. It's really cool. We came in from over here, yeah. So this route's taking us a little bit to the, yeah, we're definitely turning right at the end of the bridge. That's a big stinking support. So we're where now? I saw a sign that said West Paris, but that was off a little further. I don't know what town we're in. Nice church. We're still in Maine, I would assume. Yeah. I haven't seen another state sign yet. Okay, so Adrian ran out of fuel, and he just pulled off the side of the road and said, go, go, I'll catch up with you. So now I'm leading this small group of people behind me, either out of follow the leader or because I'm the slow one and they can't get around me, I don't know which. Yeah, so just following the dotted line here and trying to maintain something resembling the speed limit so I don't keep everybody waiting. And we're doing okay. Up most of the hills, we're getting 37 to 45 range up the modest hills. The steep hills get much, much worse for us. We could get down into the 20s, maybe low 30s. So we have to drop down to second gear sometimes. But all in all, we're doing okay. My cub is running a little more efficient than Adrian's, and I really think it's because of that 15-tooth front sprocket, and he's also got a barn door windscreen that probably adds a little more drag, but I'm flashing. I've been flashing for quite a while, so I'm just about out of fuel too. Sometime it's going to start sputtering and coughing and complaining that it's running out of go-go juice. So I will be pulling off the highway here soon-ish. There's the second gear. I got to really pin it to maintain any kind of speed. Yeah, they got tired of waiting behind me. Good. Still have a couple of patient ones back there. Just keep on running until this thing coughs, and I'll stop and put fuel in it. I should have started recording from the beginning of this road. Twisty, twisty. And somehow we're off track here. Hang on. Let me figure out. You know where we're going. I'm just going to follow you. We're not on the track line anymore. I don't know where we turned off, but whatever. Okay. Yeah, we're off, we're west of the track, but maybe that's where the ambulances and all that stuff were back there. We'll have to find out if they were just spectating it, or if it was one of the Cannonball members that was tied up in it. Because there was a red Forza sitting there. It was parked, it was upright, and the rider, riding suit, standing next to it, so I don't know. Well, slow and steady on these things is the better idea. Very calm water out there. Almost glass smooth. Radius downhill off camber. Let's throw three variables in there. Big dinner and call it done. You said 370 something today? I'm looking for how far. 377? We are 185 or so into it right now. So we're about at the halfway. we're about the halfway point. My odometer says 195, and had probably, you know, 10 miles on there from our fill-up before we made it to the hotel this morning. But my odometer reads 6% low. So. Downhill, fourth gear ain't doing it. Down to 35, third gear, still dropping, 28, 30, 29, yep. Second gear, 62 downhill and 27 uphill. Okay, everyone, well, welcome to the finish of day one here at the Hampton Inn and Suites. We're not staying here. Well, we might stay here. We haven't decided yet. We've got Emerald Lake Campground about 15 minutes from here, but it sure would be easier to start and finish from here. So we're debating whether we want to spend $150 and split a room. Well, we'll see. Anyway, quite a few of the bikes have already taken off. Benji just took off a minute ago. He's got another hotel down the road. We were exchanging notes. He was real interested in the trailers, and we were talking about how the Cubs did, and he got in here an hour before we did. I mean, put that in perspective. We were just absolutely full tilt, crushing as hard as we could, 52, 54 most of the time. That means he was probably running easily 60 most of the time to get here an hour before we did. But he's traveling fast and light. So anyway, we got scoots of all flavors. We got people tearing stuff apart over here, pulling swing arm off of a scoot. They were looking for a gear puller in order to get in there, so I'm not sure what's broken or if they're just upgrading or not sure. But GoPam was here earlier. She took off. She found a room somewhere else. But it's a pretty successful first day, with the exception of one spot. I don't know if my camera was recording or not. But we had a rider go down at a fork in the road where this side went down, this side went up, and there was a little bit of gravel on the split, and as they rounded the corner, they downed the bike. So unfortunately, that person is out of commission. The bike is messed up, and from last I heard, he was being transported to a trauma center. I don't think it's life-threatening, but it's probably broken leg and some other stuff, maybe a broken hip. So that's bad. That's real bad. Low-sided on some gravel. Not a good way to start or end the event for anybody. So we got the scoring truck over here. The app seemed to work pretty well. We were taking pictures, but if you didn't have cellular connectivity, then it couldn't upload the photos automatically. So luckily I thought ahead on that, and I was taking local pictures on my phone, and we can upload them after the fact and edit times if we have to or whatever. But it's mainly the checking in, checking out at each point, and making sure that you've got your mandatory checkpoints. Otherwise, you get a DNF for the day. So no DNFs here. I got them all. We got all the bonus points today too, because they were kind of on the route. Nothing was really out of our reach. So for the gravel days and some other spots that might be a little harder to get to, we might skip some of the bonuses. But yeah, other than that, it's a pretty good day. It was a light day today. Not quite 400 miles. I think it was 377 miles. So I was commenting, hell, this was easy. Unfortunately, tomorrow's going to be a 500 mile day. So yeah, that might be a different animal. But anyway, we're going to figure out whether we're getting a room here or going camping and get some food, because we haven't eaten all day long. I just had a cup of coffee free from the lobby, and I'm going to get another one of those, and it's time to get food. So I'll catch you all later.
Someone left the helmet at the front desk. All right, fellow early risers. Okay, good morning all. I don't know if you can hear me through the helmet. I'm holding my helmet next to me and talking. It's been pissing rain all night. We just got a break, maybe. We hope. It's not raining now. It's 5:20 in the morning. And we're gonna load up the bikes. So, hopefully this little hiatus in the weather here will continue long enough for us to really get on the road. But the forecast is calling for more rain off and on all day long. Even where we're going in Pennsylvania, Grove City or something like that, it's supposed to be raining as well most of the day, like 60% chance or something like that. So we're going to be going through this all day long, off and on, I'm sure. As long as it's not just monsoon rain, we'll do okay. But, you know, Murphy's Law. No motorcycle trip is a motorcycle trip without some rain. That's our room up there with the lights on. We're done. We didn't moto camp the entire event like we were thinking, but you know, we were planning on grabbing rooms every now and then anyway, so this worked out. We found some guys that were sharing a room, and we hopped on, so four of us in one room, and that lowered the costs. But anyway, good old road tripping on a motorcycle in the rain. At least we've got these trailers and pretty much waterproof boxes. Not 100% waterproof, but we've got weather strip around the underside of that lid where it seals, and so far they've been dry inside. But anyway, this is morning. We're gonna finish loading up, see if we can grab a little bit of coffee, maybe some hot water to make oatmeal, and on the road we go. Not leaving yet. I'm just gonna ride up and around to the front lobby, see if we can snag some breakfast real quick. The continental breakfast isn't supposed to be out until 6, but we'll see if we can sweet talk them. It's only about 5:35, 5:40 right now. About 10 minutes, I guess, to pack everything on the bikes, make sure that we got it all square before we hit the road. Lots of little details. I'm going to leave this open because I'm going to get right back in there in a moment. Okay. Fire up the wet bike. Pitter, 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 pitter. Strap on my hydration pack in a little bit, obviously before I leave. And yeah, that's that. Air Hawk is absolutely soaking wet, but doesn't matter, I got my rain pants on. Otherwise, that's an unpleasant surprise in the morning. You're all ready to go, sit down. Ah, wet crotch. So there were a bunch of bikes staging up here in the drive-thru. Yeah, a couple of them already took off. I'll stage here, go grab some breakfast, and yeah, let the torture begin. Lights are still out. Nope, no continental breakfast yet. So it's going to be coffee. We've got hot water here. They've been making coffee nonstop all night, which is just fantabulous. Haven't checked their hot water jug there, but if they've got hot water, we can make oatmeal. I don't think we want to wait around until 6, even though that's just a few minutes down the road. We'll see. Oh, light roast. I missed that one. Same one, I guess. Okay. Go out and socialize before everybody takes off. See if we're going to crack out the oatmeal or not. If so, I've got to unstrap my tire so I can get in the box. Fellow rider from Texas. Howdy.
You guys all packed up already?
Oh, yeah. Yours is a Kimco what? 300?
X-Town
300. How's your exhaust holding up? No problems?
It's actually good.
Yeah? That crack isn't getting any worse? Oh, there you go. Yeah. Wired up.
Yeah, it's...
Good.
I'm having tires changed in Wisconsin. I hope they don't mind messing with
me. Yeah. Yeah, you'll have to cut that and redo it because you got to pull the exhaust for the tire. He had a break in his exhaust mount.
and they welded it up before he left the Texas area, but we noticed when he got up here to Maine, there's a new crack forming in that same bracket. So this is GoPam.
Come here, warrior. Is my garment on this wetness or not?
Yeah, won't hurt it.
It won't?
Yeah, no, they're waterproof. Okay. You're fine. Yep.
Okay.
No worries.
And I, okay, wait. Alan here and...
Aaron.
Aaron is Quasi. Yep. I probably am going to call you Quasi.
Yeah, Quasi's easier. No, there's too many Texas. We got four or five of us here. We got at least five. Oh, okay, okay, okay. You win.
Your shotgun, you know?
All right.
It's Paychex Allen, all my name.
Oh,
right, right, right.
You guys ride together then?
No, no. He got out later than we did.
You guys meet here?
Yeah. Yeah, well, we discussed on the forums, I think. We batted a couple messages back and forth.
But Houston, I'm from Austin.
Yeah.
Okay.
And there were a couple of others from the Houston area, and then there was another guy from the Dallas area, but I don't know if he made it. So, anyway, I'm going to socialize, eat some oatmeal, and get the hell on the road. Okay, good morning all. It is 6 a.m., 6:05, something like that. We got out a little later than we were originally planning, but yeah, we figured it's going to be a giant hurry today because these wet roads, we got to take it easy. It's going to be a long, hard slog today. 500 miles, just short of 500. What is it, Adrian? 497? I don't think he can hear me. Yeah, last time I looked at the sheet, it was 497 miles today. So we're looking at a solid 13 hours of riding, I think, by the time we factor in our fuel stops. And probably a little longer than that with weather delays, because we're going to be looking at rain off and on all day long. So I think probably going to be a 14-hour day for us. We'll see. And this isn't the longest day on the sheet. It seems like there was one day that was 527 miles or something like that. It's a little over 500. So today and tomorrow are going to be very long ones, right up around the 500-mile mark. And I wonder how many people are just going to say, F it. And quit. We'll find out. I won't, but I probably wish that I had. My butt's gonna be killing me. Yesterday, the 400-mile day, it was pretty good right up until, you know, the end. The last 30 minutes or so, my butt was finally saying, okay, get off, gotta move around, get rid of the pressure points. But that's the cannonball. So we're gonna have a lot more of this morning. It's gonna be dark and dreary and drizzly off and on here. I looked at the forecast and it looked like we're gonna have a little reprieve from the weather for a few hours as we go more to the west, but then as we're arriving in the next state, we're gonna have some more issues. So we'll see how it goes. Catch you all on the road. So where are we in New York? Bump. Not bad. Where are we? We're somewhere in New York. I don't know where. I have no clue. Is it? So we're following Google Maps, and it's taking us off the main track. We're going south of the normal route. Really steep hills back here, but it's nice. I'm trying to save some time and not let the other riders see where we're turning. Of course, if they're following Google Maps, they're going to be doing the same thing. But it seems like most of the people are following the prescribed route, and we noticed yesterday that it was saving us time, because we were showing up ahead of people that had passed us previously. So it either means that their route was longer or they missed a turn. We don't know. You know, know, you start out not caring about the points and the scoring and all that, but then it gets competitive. If I can beat them on technicalities, I'll do it. Because I certainly can't beat them on speed. These poor little cubs are living their life wide open for this 9,500 mile trip. Oh yeah, oh this is a second gear hill. Oh, chirp, 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 chirp. Yep, under 30, so. Oh yeah, second gear, here we go. These are 15 to 18% grades back here. Some of them, we went up one earlier that was easily a 25% grade. Even in second gear, we were bogging down and had to drop to first, so yikes. So we'll see if our little shortcut, yep, see, our shortcut went around. They went around the top side, we came around the bottom side. It looks like we're gonna intersect the main route here in just a second, and we'll see if we've caught up to anybody. We're trying to keep the hammer just pinned on these little things because the hills are killing us. Just absolutely murdering us. Eight and a half horsepower pulling our body weight plus, you know, probably 80 pounds worth of trailer and gear behind us. Not doing great. But we're soldiering on. We're going to make it. I think. We'll see. Okay, so we're intersecting the main track here. I don't see any other scooters coming that way, so we either didn't catch anybody or we're ahead of them. Because at our last checkpoint, there were a whole bunch of scooters that pulled up right behind us, taking pictures. We had a slow pit stop that time because we had to refuel. Probably should film more of those, oh well. Just grab our jerry cans and funnel another gallon of fuel in the tiny little tank and hit the ground running. Okay. I can't tell. On here it looks straight, but if you have a shortcut, we take the shortcut. Adrian is running Google Maps on his phone, and I'm running the Garmin and the Trick Tracks just to see if we're somewhat close to the prescribed route, and more importantly, this gives us zoom ups on the waypoints. He's punching in the waypoints into Google Maps, so it's giving him turn by turn and hopefully shortcuts. And then we're just ratifying off of this, so, you know, that's the game for, you know, 12 more hours. Jesus. 497 miles is the route today, and we are 88 plus 6%, so we're 95 miles into this trip, so not even a fifth. Yeah, straight ahead. We're not even a fifth the way through with this torture for today. And then tomorrow, I think we got another 500-mile day. Yikes. Tuck in. 70 down the hill. 71. On your right side. Good look at the trailer in action. 70 miles an hour doing its job. Got him on the downhill. Yeah, that's the top speed that I've hit on the trip several times, is 71 pulling the trailer downhill. Haven't been able to get 72. Okay, he's telling me left in half a mile. And then uphill, you know, 35. 70 downhill, 35 uphill. Well, take a look at the views out here. Look at that.
clouds set up just on the edge of the mountains over here. It's gorgeous. If I could look at it just down the road. Rolling green hills. Gorgeous. A stop sign here. No stop ahead, just a stop sign. Left or right or straight, what are we doing?
Straight.
Yeah, because I don't even see this on the map. On the map, this street ahead of us doesn't exist. It does not. Straight? Okay, go.
It doesn't exist. The map doesn't show it at all. Yeah, it's a brand new road. Yeah.
So to the people that have asked me before in the videos, why do I run with GPS on my phone and a hard GPS? There's your answer right there. We're in a field as far as this thing is concerned. Sometimes Google knows about stuff that Garmin doesn't. Yep, we are off-roading right now, officially. Man, look at those hills. That is just gorgeous. How'd you like to have this as your backyard? Isn't this beautiful? Sharp left, 20. Gravel, gravel, gravel. Yep, you are correct, sir. Don't want to hit that going too fast. This is gorgeous. Oh my God. And it's like a picture. It's just so beautiful out here. I want to look at it, but I got to pay attention to the road. Oh, look at that. Oh, crap. Be stuck here looking at it all day. Check out the wisps of fog and clouds at the top of this mountains over there, the hills, whatever they are. Mountains to me, shit, I'm a flatlander. And it's gorgeous. We're headed right to it, slowly. Oh, they're right ahead of us. Look at that. Oh, that's so cool looking. Trying to aim the camera and look my eyes the other way. Quintessential farmhouse here. Okay. Quintessential farmhouse and silo here. That's gorgeous. Whoa, that's steep. You're gonna find out. Just don't go straight. That shit. You go straight, that shit's gonna hurt. Well, it's like that one that we took to get on this. It said private driveway on the side of the road. I thought, well, what the hell are we turning in a driveway for? Okay, then. And we just intersected the main route. So here we go left, yeah? No? Left, right? Okay, all right. Well, left is the official route, it looks like. Uh-huh. Sure we're going the right way? No? Okay, no, it's correct. All right. I don't know. It's just weird looking. Yeah, maybe. For sale, old buggy. Okay. On we go. Wow, look at that, right. Unadilla River. Unadilla River. River back there. I've never heard of it. Chobani. I've heard of them. Chobani. Wonder if this is the main place or just one of many. Chobani. They make the yogurt and all that kind of stuff. Okay,
everyone, welcome to Grove City, Grove something in Pennsylvania, end of day two. I am at the Hilton, and we got here in a torrential rainstorm, and we were doing prep on the bikes and checking them out and making sure everything was okay. And this tire looks to be okay. You know, look, I've got plenty of tread, right? Plenty of tread. Ooh. There's a different color here. What's going on? Oh. Cords. That is crazy. And I haven't locked my tire. I don't slide it. I don't do anything like that. So these Michelin pilots, looking at the profile, you can tell it's a little squared off. Oops, there we go. I'm back on camera. It's a little squared off, but it looks like it's wearing this side much more than it was wearing this side. Axle seemed to be aligned. It was riding okay. That's no bueno. I rode through a horrible rainstorm and saw this when I got here. So had to change my tire, and this is new leaving Houston. So maybe 3,200 miles on this, and it's already worn through to the cords. But what's odd is, I don't know if that's showing up on camera, you can see the different color of the rubber compound, and it's real thin and sticky right here, where the rest of it's not. And it's only like that in this one patch of tire going along here. Really odd. So I'm wondering if this is a defective tire somehow. You could really see it right there. I don't know if that's shown up on camera. You can see that stripe. That's strange. And it's only like this on one side of the tire. You go over here, it's fine. And the tire's not out of balance. It was riding just fine. So I don't know. Really weird. Anyway, so now I've got to order another tire or two, because if this is only 3,200 miles, the new one that I just put on the back isn't going to get me to California. So, fun.